Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakah. This is Asaduzzaman Asad. My nickname is Asad. I'm the trainer of the mentors at Joshua campus. And especially I'm working about 15 years as a trainer, especially in IELTS, spoken English, phonetics and advanced grammar, or as a writing instructor. So here I'm sitting today to give you some ideas and information about our facilities, what type of facilities that are available in the mentors Josh campus. So, dear viewers and dear learners and dear guests, you are presented here today to get some ideas about spoken English and IELTS. So, wish you all the best and you are most welcome to attend today's session. And from this clip or this session, you will get a very clear concept on how to learn smart English or how to get a good score in IELTS or what you should do actually, what's the requirements for our success. Hello dear viewers, English শেখার মজার মজার দারুন সব টিউটোরিয়াল পেতে আমাদের চ্যানেলটি এখনই সাবস্ক্রাইব করুন. So, I think you'll enjoy this session here today. So, first of all, I have a question for all of you that if I ask you what spoken English, what will you answer? Yeah. You can say that spoken English, it refers to speaking English. It's very simple, it's very clear. But there are some things to realize first of all from the core of your heart, that spoken English, to talk in English language, it's not your mother tongue. It's very clear to all of us that our first language is Bengali, whether Bengali speaking people, whether citizen of Bangladesh, whether people of Bengali speaking people especially, and it's a Southern Asian country in Bangladesh and where the cities of this type of country. But after being a Bengali speaking person, how is it possible for you to speak English fluently just like the native speaker, maybe the speaker of Canada, America, Australia or any other English speaking country in the world? And I want to make it clear for you that that's possible for you to become a very smart speaker or fluent speaker, and you will be also able to talk English just like the native speaker. But how is possible? That's the main question here today. Yeah, it's possible, but how? For this region, if you start first of all without knowing any techniques or the policies or without the help of any special trainer or the expert trainer, that may be somehow difficult or intricate for you to get the ultimate success. For this reason, first of all, what you should do? You should try to get some concepts. How I should approach, how I should go, how I should start here first of all. So, first of all, the prerequisites to become a very good speaker in English, you should know some vocabularies. This very simple matter, because if I want to talk in English without vocabulary, how is it possible for me to talk in English? It's never possible. So, simply, we know some vocabularies, and that will be so helpful for us to make sentence. So, first of all, after knowing some vocabularies, you have to try to make some simple sentences, not too long, or not too hard. It will be so easy, it will be transparent, it will be so convenient to understand your listener when you talk to them. So first of all, try to make some simple sentences, and after that you will try to express the sentences at the time of talking. Sometimes it may be that you may forget some sentences that you have learned already to talk, but it doesn't matter. Don't worry about this matter, just forget that as much as you can remember and try to deliver at the time of talking to your listener or other speakers. So in this way, you should start, and after that, you always think that you are a beginner, you are learning, it's your primary stage, and for that reason, first of all, you must remember the fact in your mind that you may make some mistakes. There may create some mistakes in a grammatical sense, or the sentences making, or the formation, or any other side. I don't want to say any word that you may make some mistakes, but it doesn't matter, try to forget them. And just go ahead. Your sentence may be right or wrong, it doesn't matter. You only think that you are able to make your listener to understand what you intend to say. So that's possible for you, first of all. So it may be right, it may be wrong, it doesn't matter. Just you should go on. You should go on speaking, keep expressing your emotion to others. So, don't worry about your mistakes, or don't worry about the grammatical mistakes, or the tense, or etc. Okay? So, only you should say, yes, if you wanna say, Ami bhat khai. You can say, I rice eat. You need not say, I tries. Because you're a beginner, you're a weak learner, but you're very interested to learn math, English, and for this reason, first of all, you should have the habit of speaking wrong. So don't worry about your mistakes. And first of all, never give emphasis on the perfection, but give emphasis that you are able to say something or not. That's the main point here. So try to realize what I'm telling. That's very much emergency for most of the learners, because we see that most of the learners, what they should simply, what they do at the time of beginning or at the time of the first couple of days, try to make some mistakes, but they don't worry about those mistakes. But I want to say, I want to advise them that don't worry about this mistake. Try to forget them and just you keep speaking. That's the main point. But it's very simple that we may be somewhat tense, or there may some tension create in our memory that I'm making wrong, what they're thinking about me. Oh no, it's my matter of self-respect. But don't worry about this matter if you are a beginner. But if you are able to speak English already, if you are able to express yourself, then I should say, now it's the suitable time for you to make the correct sentence. You should try to be careful about how to make the correct sentence. You should also be careful at the grammatical mistakes or sentence formation, and your sentence must be smart and advanced. And that's the time for you to now to make it more attractive. Yeah, I think that you're already doing this, or you're trying to do that right now, or already you have done this. So now you're able to speak English smartly or fluently, or you're a fluent speaker. I may think that right now you're a fluent speaker, you are able to express yourself and you can talk to me or any other person smartly and fluently. Okay, so what you should do right now? Yes, right now I'm gonna talk to you that it's a very important suggestion. You can take it and be serious about this matter, what I'm telling right now, to make it clear. Try to be very careful about your pronunciation. That's very much important to make your pronunciation correct and attractive right now, because I think you're very interested to talk English like the native speaker, like the English. Am I right? Yes, you're right. And I'm also right that you're very interested to talk English like the native speaker, like the American people, Canadian, Australian people. So this is the suitable time for you to give me precise on your pronunciation at the time of speaking. And for this reason, you should try to be very careful about your pronunciation. And for this reason, if you want to learn smart English, learn smart pronunciation. So I will tell that try to learn phonetics. What I've told? Phonetics. P-H-O-N-E-T-I-C-S. Phonetics. Phonetics. You should learn. And if you're able to learn phonetics, then it will be so easy for you to speak English very smartly, or maintaining the correct rules and procedures of right pronunciation. And that will be so sweet and interesting and also attractive to your listeners. And then you'll be considered as a very smart speaker. So there's very much emergency for all of us to talk like this way. But most of the speakers, they don't give an emphasis on the phonetics or on the correct pronunciation. They can think that, yeah, my days are passing simply, so I need not to give emphasis on the pronunciation. But I want to say that if you're interested to go abroad to make international business, or to make international communication or effective communication with the foreigners, or people are interested to go any English-speaking country for any type of research or higher education or any other purposes, or if you're interested to take IELTS. Already you have taken decision to take IELTS, okay, that's fine. But you can think that there's the four parts of IELTS: reading, writing, listening, speaking. And for this reason, what you should do, the first of all, I'm gonna say to make it clear that about reading. Okay, if you want to understand after reading a passage, if you want to comprehend the total substance, what's the main features of the passage, then you should try to know the meaning of the vocabulary first of all. And simply you should keep in mind that in the IELTS vocabulary, that's not a simple vocabulary. So most of the passages, you'll see that they are hyphenated, or the advanced label vocabularies they use simply to make a passage. And for this reason, you need to get idea about the advanced label vocabularies. That will be so easy for you to comprehend the passages, and it will be also easy to answer the questions in the IELTS reading part. So you need to know rich vocabularies, and it is very emergency or important to make your vocabulary power more increased. It should be powerful, otherwise it will be so difficult for you to understand the IELTS reading passages. And not only the passage session, if you want to write something, see, if I talk about the writing part, then you should write the smart vocabulary, smart sentences. And for this reason, you should know the smart English, If you wanna make a good score in the IELTS writing part, then you should know how to write a smart sentence. What type of vocabularies you should use, and also the sequence of tenses or the formation of the sentences, and that should be so advanced level and rest. Otherwise, you'll not be able to get a good score in the writing part. That's very important for you. So, it will be really so helpful both the reading and the writing sides, and not only reading and the writing side, but it will be also helpful in future. Other speaking part also, speaking. If you wanna talk smartly, if your pronunciation is very smart and it's so clear, and if your sentences are also very formative and advanced level, then it will be so easy for you to get a good score in our speaking part also. So every part you're getting the facilities for the pronunciation of the phonetics scale. So try to get yourself scaled and exact and the smart pronunciation. And for this reason, you need to complete your phonetics course. Where will you take the phonetics course? No problem. You needed to go to Dhaka or Khulna or any other big cities or the divisional cities. Just to hear, it's a regional cities and the, I think, southern cities. And just sure, here in the mentors, you're getting the smart phonetics course. But you have to come here, you have to talk to me, you have to get all the information, and then finally you have to think that you are decided or not to take this type of smart course. Finally, if you're ready, if you're prepared, then by the name of Allah, you can start your expedition here to make yourself more smart, and you will be very smart speaker, inshallah. I'll try and solve for you to give all type of facilities that are available in the mentors and Joshua campus. I'm giving you the words as a teacher. So there's nothing to worry about this matter. Oh yes, I forgot to tell another matter, one more thing. Yes, right now I'm gonna talk to the listening part of IELTS. Listening. So listening part, whatever, they will give you the special headphone at the time of listening test in the IELTS part. And you'll get 30 minutes or I mean half an hour to complete about 40 questions answers. To complete, you'll get how much time? Half an hour, I mean 30 minutes. And within this time, you have to complete the answers about almost 40 questions. But where's the problem will create? Yeah, at the time of listening, who are talking on the audio? Yeah, the native speaker are talking. And directly, the British people will talk at the time of listening. But if you're not habituated to understand, or if you're not habituated with the pronunciation of British people, then it will be so difficult for you to understand. So it will be really so negative for you to make a good score in the listening part. And for this reason, try to be very careful. Sometimes what you see and simply what you do at home, just try to understand what I'm telling. It's a TV, television, and at home, we're trying to watch a movie here. And when you watch the movie, when you see the movie, can you tell me frankly from your heart that you are able to understand how in person they are all speaking, they're all speech? Do you understand how in person? I think you'll answer no, sir. Really, this is sometimes it becomes so intricate for us to gaze what's the telling, what's the speech or accent or intonation or the pronunciation. That's really so intricate for us to understand. It's sometimes it becomes so hazy, it's unclear, we can't catch them, we can't understand them. But what's the problem? Because you're not habituated with your accent or pronunciation. And if you're interested to habituate it, if you're interested to talk like them, and not only like them, but also you're interested to speak like them, and I think phonetics course is must for you. So if you're able to complete a phonetics course, then it will be so easy for you to understand their speech at the time of watching an English movie or drama. It will be easy like you to watch or to understand, I think. So this is reality. What I'm telling you is not a false truth. Try to realize from your heart this fact what I'm telling. So guys, try to try to understand. This is very emergency for all of us. So if you're able to speak English already, so you must take phonetics course. That will be easy for you to cut a good figure in the IELTS part, especially speaking, listening. So it's really so interesting. And if you're able to speak English like the native speaker, all the people around you, they'll appreciate you a lot, that you're a very good speaker. They like you, they'll respect you for this quality. So try to acquire this quality. Why are you sitting motionless? Try to change your life. Try to learn smart English. And this is the suitable place for you to learn smart English. To my mind, if you are an inhabitant right now of Jeju district, so I try to catch it up. to take this type of smart course from this place. But actually, this is true that I'm not telling you to make you convinced to take this type of course. It's your decision. It's your own decision. You can do or not. It doesn't matter. But as a teacher, I'm giving you the all information, all tips here. How you can become a very good speaker, very good debater, very expert in English. So there's the information. And for this region, what I should follow actually here, just you can see, it's a book. Smart Spoken English. There's the mentors. Books that we follow simply to complete any type of smart or especially the course. To make you complete the special smart spoken course, you should follow these materials. And here, I think if you follow very clearly or your attention, it will be clear for you to just write phonetics here. Smart spoken English and also phonetics here. Phonetics. I think you can see and understand. Okay. So this book is not only for spoken part, but also for the phonetics part. So you can collect this material from our institute. If you want to become a learner of this institute, our door is always open to you. But you have to come here, you have to talk to me, you have to get all information. That will be easy for you to take the final decision. So that's very important. And also, spoken and phonetics parts, that will be so interesting for you to learn smart English. It will be so helpful for you to get a good score in speaking or the listening part also. And also in IELTS, what we simply suggest our learners to follow right now, and I assure you. If you're an IELTS learner, then you must follow the Cambridge. Cambridge all version. Here, I think you can see that the Cambridge here, it's recent Cambridge IELTS, okay? And there's so many parts and already our latest version 1 to 14. But I think you need not to complete all the versions, but you should follow the latest version and you should give emphasis on the latest version. A latest version, I don't say that. Here, see this. This is IELTS. Another part is IELTS 11. And IELTS 11 to IELTS, no, I'm sorry. Once again, I'm repeating it to make you clear. That IELTS 10 to 14, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, you should follow to make a good score in IELTS. And not only Cambridge, but in order to make our learners very much good in IELTS preparation, I suggest them also to complete the Barron's IELTS. It's Barron's, you can say Barron's IELTS. They're the six parts here is special, so you should complete. If you are interested to get a good screen IELTS part, you must complete not only Cambridge, but also you should try to follow the Barron's. And simply, both the types of preparation is taken here in the mentors. I suggest, and I personally, I teach Cambridge, also Barron's. And there are some others, extra materials of our institute that I should say all of you to follow to make a good score, especially. So, dear guys, I think you got an idea about all the things here. You're clear now that what you should do actually to get a good score in IELTS part and what you should do actually to become a very good speaker, a smart speaker in English. Yes, you can take your smart spoken English course in the mentors. So that's all about the information. So actually, I don't like to prolong our tutorial right now. So Anna, I'll make your finishing. So if you have any more queries, if you have any more questions to know anything in details, then you can also talk to me or you can take suggestion from me. So that's all about the tutorial. I'm finishing. I wish you all the best. Take care.